All right. Our first guest tonight is one of those, whenever I talk to people and they ask me who I would most like to have on the show, I always mention his name. I love him. I know our announcer, Dickie, actually has I Am, I Said, tattooed on his body.
That's true.
This man is the writer of more than 40 top 40 hits. He sold more than 120 million albums. His latest, with help from legendary producer Rick Rubin, is great. It is one of the best albums of an already amazing career. It debuted at number 4 this week on the Billboard charts. It's called 12 Songs. Please say hello, my friends. Hello to Neil Diamond. And thank you so much for coming. I've been chasing you around for 3 years. I was bordered on stalking.
Well, I'm happy you did it.
Yeah, thank you for coming. I saw you about a month ago at the Staples Center, and just fantastic. Not only have you not lost a step, you actually, I think, just keep getting better and better and better as you go. Okay. Really great. Thank what you. A great show.
Thank you.
And I apologize if I kiss your ass too much. Just let me know.
I'm enjoying it.
All right,
so
good.
Go right ahead.
A lot of guys get sick of performing as much as you do. You must love still doing it.
I do love it. I do love it. Every day is different. It's fabulous.
You have the same group of people that you tour around with?
Yeah, pretty much exactly the same as years ago.
Wow.
They've hung out with me and. And it's been great.
How is everybody different in as far as like 25 years ago?
There's a lot of difference. I mean, we all grow up. The audiences grow up. I'm playing bigger places now. But there's always been one constant in my group, and that's our poker game. We've played. It's the longest running poker game in rock and roll.
Wow.
And we're still friends.
Yeah.
We control the bidding, you know, it's $1 or $2 and control, so we stay friends. We learn some lessons along the way. But it's been going on and
you play every night after the show?
Not every night, but
most
many nights.
Are you up nights. Over the would you say over the course?
I'm so far over the last 30 years I'm $300 ahead.
Oh, is that right? Wow. That's $10 a year.
Hey.
that's not bad at all. So you play for pretty low stakes, and the guys in the band don't lose just to make sure they have a gig?
I wish they would.
You wish they would.
You know, they're very happy to take whatever I foolishly bet.
You said your audience gets older as you go, but, I mean, when I was at the Staples Center, I mean, a good 50% of that audience was under 40 years old. Does that surprise you to see that?
I guess it does, but it started happening about 10 or 15 years ago where lots of young people started coming, and now, as you say, it's about half the audience is young people and half are the old faithful, you know, fans that I love and will cherish forever.
Yeah. It really is something. You did this great show. You're on for about 2 hours, and then still you have so many hit songs that at the end of it, it's like you could still name 8 songs that you didn't get to. People come, I know, to like, they'll come to 5 shows in a row just so they can kind of cover every base.
I like those people.
You like those people? I don't blame you. I know you have, at a time you dressed very flamboyantly, almost.
Yeah. On stage.
Elvis did. Yeah, on stage. Oh, you weren't wearing those jumpsuits?
No, I didn't. I haven't tried it.
Now, you've kind of put that away, and in fact, in your new album, in a way, you've done that musically, too.
Yeah, yeah. It's a very simple, unadorned album, very direct, very intimate, and maybe not a lot like the shows, which are very flamboyant and very overt. And
it's great. You did it with Rick Rubin, and I guess this is the biggest debut you've had ever on the charts, right?
It is, yeah.
That's something else.
I got a call from Don Einar, who's president of Sony Records, and he said, you know, by the way, the album debuted at number 4 around the country, and I was Yeah. It's never happened before.
It's great. It really is great.
It is.
I've listened to it already like 30 times, and there's some really great songs on there.
Thank you, Jim.
Yeah, and Rick Rubin, for people that don't know, produced the Beastie Boys. He produced Run DMC. All your contemporaries.
That's right.
He produced Johnny Cash. How did you know about Rick, and how did you guys come together?
Well, I mean, everybody in the music business knows about Rick because he is kind of legendary and extraordinary producer, but the two of us have been kind of playing tag for the last 10 years, and we finally did get together about 3 years ago and started working, and we liked each other, and we liked what we respected each other, maybe more important than just liking each other, and we started to work on this album, and it evolved, it developed, it became what it was, and I'm thrilled with it, and the response has been unbelievable. I haven't seen this in my whole career.
There's a song that I want to ask you about, a couple of songs. Number one, I Am, I Said, how does it go exactly? It's no one there, and no one heard a sound, no one heard at all, not even the chair.
Yeah. Well, this was a very intelligent chair, and he just wasn't listening.
Because Dr. Phil had some trouble with some chairs earlier in the show. Oh, well, there it is, right there. Yeah. That is not the chair that, no. Okay, that's a different chair entirely. The other thing I always wondered about is the song Heartlight.
Yeah.
You wrote it because you enjoyed the movie E.T.
Yeah.
How did that work? You went to the movie and you said, I gotta write a song about this thing.
That's basically what happened. I was with a couple of people that I knew very well who were terrific writers, and we saw the movie together, and we said, come on, let's get together and write. We did, right from the movie theater. We went up to an apartment and took out... this is Burt Bacharach and Carol Sager.
Uh-huh.
And we got sat down. Burt sat at the piano. I pulled out my guitar. We just wrote this song. I didn't know it would do anything. It was a top five record, which I was very surprised at. But it happened just like that. And a lot of these things are unplanned. And they're usually better when they're unplanned.
So many people have covered your songs. Of course, UB40 did Red Red Wine. Elvis has covered The Monkees.
That's right.
I'm a Believer is your song. Frank Sinatra has. What is your favorite of all the... some of them aren't even covered. Songs that you've written for people or covers?
Well, I mean, I have a lot of favorites, but I have to say, of all the people that have recorded my songs, Sinatra and Presley, and some of the greatest of our generation, there's one in particular that I loved, and it's got to be my favorite. As a matter of fact, we brought a video here. I don't know, can they play it here, the video?
Yeah. What is this?
Where it begins, I can't begin to know it. But then I know it's growing strong.
Oh, that's just terrible.
Was in the spring.
Yeah.
And the spring became the summer.
There'll be heads are gonna roll after the show tonight.
I'm taking my name off that song.
That was not so sweet, Caroline. No. Yeah, that's a big karaoke song. Oh no,
that's right.
Oh no, there's not. Yeah, you see, I have a lot of stage presence. Thank you very much. Well, that's embarrassing.
Well, you know, you do have a sound. I hear a sound in your voice, which is interesting, very unusual.
I want you to know that before everyone started impersonating you, my plan for retirement was to become a Neil Diamond impersonator. And get this, what my name was going to be? Neil Zirconia. Fantastic, right?
If this doesn't work out, try it.
Absolutely.
I think you'll do it good.
Neil Diamond, everybody. This is his new record. It's called 12 Songs, in stores now. I highly recommend it. We'll be right back with Michael Irvin.
The Jimmy Kimmel Live Concert Series. presented by Coors Light.
I gotta tell you, I am almost embarrassed at how beautiful it is out here tonight in Southern California, and we are so lucky to have this man with the song I'm On to You from this, his great new album, 12 Songs, Neil Diamond.
Life, no more, I'm on to you. No, we'll score. Yeah, I'm on to you. Take anything you want, baby, I'm moving on. You can complain, rant and cry, can't deny, baby, I'm on to you. Talk your talk, I'm on to you. Like a hawk, hey, I'm on to you. Trouble is what you are, trouble that's gone too far. Baby, the truth makes you free. Disagree, I'll still be on to you. Tell me now how I was wrong, and I'll tell you how right you are. Wrong to be staying so long, was I out of my head? Should have known it was dead, but it's good. By now, I'm on to you. Stood my ground, yeah, I'm on to you. Baby, I wish you well, but loving you hurt like hell. Now is the time to let go, finally know that I'm so on to you. Dig it. Loving you hurt like hell. Now is the time to let go and finally know that I'm so on to you. Baby, I'm on to you. Saying I'm on to you, to you, to you, to you, to you.
The Jimmy Kimmel Live Concert Series, presented by Coors Light. To buy Neil Diamond's CD, 12 Songs Now, go to jimmykimmellive.net and click on the CD cover.
Monday NFL Countdown, both on ESPN throughout the football season. Thank you for being here, Michael. Anytime. 12 Songs is the album. It is in stores now. This band's going to play us off the air with Kentucky Woman. See the full performance at jimmykimmellive.net. Click the Pontiac Garage. It'll all be there. Once again, Neil Diamond. Good night.
She shines with her own kind of lights. She looks at you once in a day. That's all wrong, looks all right. And I love her. God knows I love her. Kentucky woman,
can't make heads turn in the drop of her name. But something inside that she's got turns you on just the same. And I love her. God knows I love her. Kentucky woman, she get to know you. She got on you. Kentucky woman, don't want much. Good Lord's earth beneath my feet. Gentle touch from that one girl, and life is sweet and good. Ain't no doubt. Talking about Kentucky woman, she get to know you. She got to own you.
The test that finds what your doctor can't.